tip it? How will the players that have come back into the West Coast Eagles side gel? Can they do it straight away? They need to. We're underway. Mumford and Natanui meet in the middle and get into it straight away. West Coast and Sydney. We'll see a bit of this throughout the afternoon. It'll be tight. It'll be tense.
Andrew Gaff starting in the middle of the ground as well. So an opportunity there to get in nice and tight. Winston Footy, McVeigh, his opponent.
Dalziel, type of player that needs to do his role effectively against this mighty midfield.
Be interesting at this clearance. It looked like Pritis was actually going with O'Keefe as much as O'Keefe is going with Pritis. Two of the guns of the comp.
Well, it's a good matchup, isn't it? It's different players slightly, but so
he
effective.
Did well there, Tom Mitchell. He was grabbed high, but he definitely helped the umpire make his mind up.
What an amazing first six games he's had. Averaged 22 disposals and looked completely at home at the level. Glass, Pritis. The Eagles out to the wing. Hard work done by Darling. Rampy was there with him. And Mitchell again gets involved. Everett back to Rampy again. Hurled it onto the left boot quickly. Jack Smith. And Brown did all the hard work and then almost lost it. But Schofield feeding McKenzie. And the Eagles standing firm so far. Gaff off and running. He's pursued by Kennedy. And now Marston, who's also in sparkling career best form, so much so that he's starting to draw the attention of opposition teams. Young Carter playing his second game. We saw him flash through there, number 19. Now Pritis inside the 50. Cox pleading for the umpire to pay the mark. He gets a second opportunity out to Dalziel. Dalziel puts it through. Great start for West Coast. So Brad Dalziel has been quite a revelation. No one really expected that they would get such output from him, I wouldn't think, Jared.
No, he's he was right on the edge or the cusp of his career ending, I think. But he's been given an opportunity and he's been in superb form in the last few weeks.
He's got the job of marking Hanbury by the look of that. And didn't give him much room at all.
One that's of great interest, Jono, and I'm sure Andrew Gaff is absolutely rapt that he is not being heavily tagged at the present time. When he gets the ball, the Eagles machine clicks.
Well, that's right, already had two disposals early and pushing back defensively first as a midfielder.
There was his man, Bird, getting the ball early.
And it ended with a kick going inside 50, but it comes straight back out. Last takes the mark. The Eagles moving it along. Smith.
Got to be good with your leg, and he is, and it's set up Glass. But good defence by the Swans. Smith has done really well.
Charging through, driving long, hoping that Kennedy can get there, and he did. Oh, his timing was perfect. Cox all on his own. A terrific target, and he finds in the big fella. You can hear the earth shake as he went crunching the ground.
Well, it's the thing that's been missing for the Eagles to a large degree for a majority of this season. That's a really good rebound off the half-back line. We know that Waters and Hearn have been missing, but that time Smith got the ball, kicked at the glass, and then he got on the bike, charged through, and got the overlap running through.
So Dean Cox, they haven't quite got the output of goals either from Natanui and Cox this year that they would have liked. 11 goals, 13. And he makes that one count. What a start for West Coast. They had the weaponry down there, don't they, Jono, to really trouble the Sydney defence.
Well, they do, and the focus will go towards the talls. That's when the smalls start to come into their own as well. Lacroix will start finding ball. Hill will start finding some ball as well.
Cox into the ruck then, down to Marston. Mitchell had the head down. Crunch. Hard to get it out of there. Big Mumford trying to shake a few off.
Gaff plays that receiving role, so he's in the middle of the ground, Jared, but then he goes as a bit of a sweeper. At times you'd like him to put his head down and get right in amongst it just for his own confidence.
Well, he's going to have to learn to get possessions in all sorts of ways because he's going to be heavily tagged throughout his career. But again, the Eagles coming off that half-back line with great tenacity and supporting each other.
Carter first, then Wellingham. And now Adam Selwood. Had a good game in the waffle last week.
There's the pressure.
Carter being forced back, but now they can get some forward movement. Not as much as they would have liked. The ball smothered by Mitchell. And it hasn't just been Mitchell's ball-winning ability. His tackling and his smothering, the stuff that you love, Jared, has been on display in his short career.
Well, that's just a magnificent smother. It just adds to an all-round game. And, of course, Tommy Mitchell spent his formative years here in Perth. His dad was the assistant coach of the Dockers, and for a long time he represented WA.
Nearly time to breathe there for Hanbury. They kept it moving, but with a throw, the umpire deems.
Yeah, and a good call from the umpire. He's on the job there. Good pressure from Josh Hill.
Hill out to Kennedy again. Darling's in the square. Lacroix is moving sharply to the footy here. Sliding in with Nick Smith. Another appetising battle between those two. Hutchings was able to work a handball, but Hanbury was onto it quickly. And now Kennedy can bustle his way through the middle. Interesting kick. Hit really in the middle of nowhere. And Brown was able to get the first read on it. And can guide the kick, but not accurately. Malcheski. So Malcheski's man is Cripps.
Yeah, that'll be a defensive matchup, definitely. That one, that hope Cripps, who would sneak forward and get a goal, but certainly trying to lock down on Jared McVeigh and on Milcheski.
Hutchings got it away. O'Keefe tried to lay the tackle. Yeah, it's not going anywhere just at the moment.
Yeah, Sherrod Wellingham looks like he's starting on that half forward line. It's a dangerous matchup for Jared McVeigh, because Malcheski can lock down, we know that. I think Colling was losing his lockdown ability at the present time, but he can also kick goals.
O'Keefe feeding Kennedy again. That's all about territory. It pitches in the nice way for the Swans, though. Suddenly it becomes an attacking movement forward, because look at Jesse White waiting to receive. We know he's got great athletic ability. He's got Lamb on his inside, but the goals are in his sights. And he made sure that they went right through the middle.
And how good is that as well? Running into open goal and kicked through the ball, Jared. Just didn't dribble it, made sure of it, straight through the middle as well, which is important. But it was his run to get up the ground and get back.
Yeah, controversial kick, that one. Went through the air.
Natanui got it down, but it's the Swans just starting to click into gear now, you fancy. Hanbury feeding Smith. Didn't reach the destination desired. Kennedy had to get in with a swivel this way and that. Lacroix. Oh, Lacroix. Good second effort, and Hill.
Sharp, the Eagles, yeah, very sharp.
Sharp by hand, aren't they, Smith? High ball into the pocket. It should be all Sydney. Everyone had to wait an uncomfortable length of time for it to arrive, and during that period, Cox was there to close it out.
Just a hand in on a possession by the Swans interrupted that counter-attack there. It was excellent work, and then good sharp work by Lacroix getting involved up the ground.
Natanui climbs over the top. Lacroix tried to burst through. Smith and Hill. Amazingly, Mark Lacroix in six games against the Swans has not kicked a goal.
1 metre. Mike, can you, that's a big stat. I would never have picked that along the way, because he's consistently there for at least one or two a game.
Prittis hurled it onto the booth. Again, Cox in focus, and Malcheski showing he's not all just about attack off half-back.
No, he came across nicely. Just all the best back lines through history have been supportive of each other, and Malcheski gets the job with a kick-in.
Oh, and a brilliant kick-in it was, two to half-back. Swans have just settled a little in the last few minutes after the Eagles kicked the first two goals. Hanbury, a lot of margin for error there for Nick Smith. And here he is again, Malcheski. Hard man to shut down, but they're quickly locked onto McVeigh.
Probably needed to be a kick there. There was just too many Eagles supporters in and around, and the Swans a little bit fortunate to get out of this one.
They are. They closed up his left leg, though, which was important, so made him go by hand.
A sloppy tackle, really. Just undid all their good work. So Grundy first, and now Richards collaborate again for the Swans. They're up to half four. Jesse White.
Good start by Jesse.
He's got a make or break few weeks coming up, Jesse White. He could play finals footy the way he's going, and he's delivered beautifully for Kennedy.
Well, he's always been an athletic talent, but he has been an athletic talent without work rate. And reading a column about him only during the week, he acknowledged that. And that's the start, I think, of the rebirth of his career. He's got enormous talent. You just saw there, good work rate added to good skills. He could be a really important player for this club for a long time.
They're goal-kicking midfielders, the Sydney Swans. What a feature they are. Kennedy, they're at it again. He puts it through. And back to 1 point, the difference. One point, the difference again. Marston and Kennedy ready to go at it again. Kennedy fresh from kicking the last. Natanui, we watched free spring. No, he didn't have to that time. Couldn't release it. Marston with the hands.
Push Wellingham up to the wing, and it's Shuey going with Jared McVeigh. So clearly they're going to put goal kickers on McVeigh and rotate dangerous players through to make him defend.
You've got to have a plan, don't you, Jared, I think, against those two. Well, they'll tear you to shreds, which they have done so often this year. Here's Richard. instructions. A bit slow motion stuff there after Lamb got it across to him. Up to half forward, Glass spinning well, effectively drew the high contact. The umpire paid the advantage. Marston unpaid it, but no one actually was listening to him. Carter released it across to Prittis. They've got the next one over the top. Bit of Chinese checkers action here for the Eagles. Prittis ignored the obvious option and went for something way too
Kieren Jack. Kieren Jack did that so well on that occasion, just put Prittis in two minds.
Oh, and the work rate. Kieren Jack ran from 80 metres away to get involved to block the Chinese checkers.
Everett, another one with a long ball into the square. Oh, Bolton. He would normally have swallowed that one up. And the Eagles dodge one at halfback. They can start to move the ball. Carter released it virtually as he got it, which meant it was going to be difficult to be clean and find a teammate. And it's over and out as we get down to Cameron Mooney. What have you noticed early, Moons?
Yeah, so just looking at that matchup with Cripps and Malcheski. I don't know about you, Jared, but if I was Cripps, I'd be trying to play him as deep as possible. Right now, he's running through the middle of the ground with him, which is exactly where Malcheski wants to be. He wants to get on the ends of handballs and put that ball inside 50, so they need to drag him as deep as possible.
Yeah, I think the key to that is to get the ball in Cripps' hands. Otherwise, Malcheski will dominate the positioning.
Wonderful kick to tip it. He just couldn't complete the mark, though. He had the quick look at the umpire.
Threw that, didn't he?
Yeah, he was trying to work out how to get it onto his boot or handball it out successfully. Jesse White's just about squashed the bladder out of that ball. But the umpire gets involved right on the line. Tense moments for the Eagles, who lead by one. Oh, Kieren Jack was brilliant the way he sharked it. He misses and we're all tied up.
Here's the injury first to Kurt Tibbett. Just a little jar of the leg, I would have thought, there coming down. He's and then he gets up. Let's see how he gets rid of this ball. He does get a fist on it. Well done and quite inventive.
Short kick into Hutchings. Takes the mark in the back pocket. Lacroix.
Did I invent a word there?
You were inventive the way you with the use of the English language there, Jared. But we like it. Lacroix from half back. Up to the wing, Kennedy. Some early contact was really good from Grundy. Made it hard for Kennedy to have any space to fly. And everyone wants to go off the ground down there. It's about eight blokes who wanted to go off.
Well, the heat's been on early. You'd be looking for the oxygen tent.
Scores level. Almost the halfway point of this opening to Mumford. Cox, and down it goes through Prittis' hands to Wellingham. The Eagles on the rise. Darling stood his ground, didn't try and leap, so he's kept his feet. Now he goes to ground. The Swans defence. Hanbury Cripps was there. Again, Hanbury got it from Jack, and then to Richards. A wobbly one at best to halfback. In a dangerous position as far as the Swans are concerned. Had to be clean, and they were wide. Hanbury, Parker, just winding his way through against the flow. Kick to half forward. Jack, this will test the pace. Oh, he hit the ground, but he knew he had something in reserve. It was Bird and Hanbury. He started all this way back at halfback. How's that for digging deep, Jono? Digging into those reserves and running all the way.
That's absolutely elite running right there from Hanbury, and that's the standard they set. I remember last year I was here, and it was that exact type of running that destroyed the West Coast Eagles on that occasion. Everyone sat back and said Sydney are a realistic chance to win the grand final in 2012. And that's the type of running that they perform on a weekly basis.
He's found life a little more difficult in the last months. It's been tagged, but back to his prolific best last week with 34 disposals. This one's on its way, and it gets there as well. Three consecutive goals for the Swans. That's the end of the hard running from Daniel Hanbury, from one half back to the opposite half forward, and opposite forward pocket almost.
And then to do that run, go back and kick a goal from 45.
There's the clearance numbers the Eagles need to address, and that's the best way of doing it. Shuey taken high, not for the first time, but taken high, and they get the ball forward into their top 50. And again, Gaff, he's betting a lot of the football at the present time.
Works it back to Carter. The Eagles fans not showing a lot of patience. I don't think they really like that decision-making. But West Coast have the footy, the most important thing.
Well, the Swans have pushed a lot of people back, and this is good work. Schofield pushing up the ground to get that loose ball and trying to get it to a one-on-one.
Yeah, it was a quick release kick, wasn't it, from Schofield? He saw the one-on-one, as you said, Jared, and Wellingham's able to take the mark. Their defenders got a lot of... I know Fremantle obviously have their defensive style, Jared, but West Coast defenders got a lot of the footy last week, an unusual amount of footy, and again this week they're getting plenty of it.
Well, they have been sharing it around, going from side to side, trying to find a productive way forward. Really impressed with this guy. I think he can be a significant player for this club. They've missed him greatly through the year.
92 games in 5 years at Collingwood, and in for game number four today, and that's his first goal in West Coast colours. Well, what a terrific contest we've got. West Coast getting away to a terrific start, and Sydney hitting back, and now the Eagles, after three in a row for the Swans, have the steadier and scores a level. Kennedy, they're going to work again out of the middle. O'Keefe, Bird, brilliant lateral movement to get it to Jack, and then up into the 50. Defensive work was very diligent from Smith. Transferred the heat quickly to Adam Selwood. Hutchings in there right over the top, laying tackles.
Great tackle by Bolton.
Squeeze it out. Pressure on Lamb. Brandon Jack got it to Lamb. He's ready. He's trying to work the angles out. Instead, he saw a teammate. A welcome sight was Kennedy around the corner. And Prittis happy with either result there.
Probably just beyond his distance there around the corner, but it was just really good defensive work by the Sydney Swans, sharing the ball, getting it back until somebody got a clear-cut kick.
Smith to himself. Aims the kick up. Shorter than that. Hutchings sneaking to take the mark. Cox was demanding it. Shuey likewise on the wing. Chesky may have got a fingernail to it, but the mark's still paid. So Luke Shuey off half-back after a couple of weeks out with injury.
The Swans know that they like to go inside from that position, and they really did cover those defensive players. But that's why you need somebody with the mobility of Jack Darling to present, and he did well.
He did. Took it further afield to Cripps. Hill is deep as the long option. Kick goes up in his direction. Rampy. And Kennedy is over it out now.
And Moons, that's the work you're talking about from Cripps, just getting in behind Malcheski, able to link up with Darling there.
Yeah, look, he needs to get a little bit deeper and really lead out, but be that leading forward. I think you caught it, Jared. They need to start using him, make Malcheski accountable.
Shuey.
The backstop there, the keeper. Rampy was doing it well.
Jono, it's amazing what happens when you get a goal or two kicked on you as a defender, how quickly you stop running. And that's where the Eagles really need to exploit Malcheski, is trying to get a goal on him.
Rampy, Mumford, Glass, Mitchell, clean of hand. Bolton, pretty sure of foot. And Tippett not getting any free space at all. Lovely spoil, McKenzie. Jack has just had to ride it out, just grit the teeth. He's good at doing that. O'Keefe, Tippett again. He's finding the game pretty tough so far. The heat, the energy of this game, maybe just take a little bit of adjustment for a man who had such a long layoff. Gutsy into the middle, and outstanding, unusually fumbled by Parker. Big turnover for the Eagles. Darling feeding it off Hutchings. This is important. Shuey can crank it from there, but he does lower the eyes and puts it on the chest of the hard-leading Mark Lacroix.
Well, it's just brilliant transition from the Eagles, but it was set up for the Swans to go down the other end of the ground. It just all fell apart with a fumble through the middle of the ground. And their pressure skills have been quite superb over the last month, the West Coast, and they're bringing them up against the side that is ranked number one for pressure.
Already 23 tackles in this first quarter, the West Coast Eagles.
25 goals, 24 for the season. Kicked a couple last week on an otherwise quiet day. His goal kicking has just gone awry a little this year, hasn't it? As that one goes behind, 25-25 now for the year. Enough to give the Eagles the narrowest of leads, though. As Sydney come away, those two danger men off halfback, McVeigh and Malcheski. The ball over the line and out of bounds. McVeigh just the three disposals in the opening term. And Malcheski just two. So you'd have to give that a tick for West Coast so far, Jared.
Absolutely. They would have come in knowing that they're one of the great strengths of the Swans, and they've combated it really well.
Wellingham is on McVeigh now at the moment as we speak. As the Eagles trying to probe it forward.
It's called heavy traffic in there. You've got to have clean hands.
And Shuey trying to break a couple of tackles. And a look at the way he did it, and then turned onto the left. And Lacroix takes the mark.
You're right, Jared. How good was that? Tied in traffic, strong body, great agility.
Still to kick a goal ever against the Sydney Swans, Mark Lacroix. This is going to go mighty close. Oh, Cox will help him out. No, can't quite take the mark. He's had a couple of those today. Grundy had to improvise. Rampy knew where to put the ball.
Just a pressure kick coming there, and this time it was to a 3-on-2.
Good competition from White to bring it to ground. Parker's taking a little bit of time to adjust. So this game so far, we'll have a throw up at half forward. Gee, it's a good game, isn't it?
I was going to say, this is just winding the clock back about 8 years. A classic, hopefully, in the making.
Hanbury. Around the corner goes Parker. Bolton, who was there all through those fantastic clashes, to Kennedy, who would have been right at home in such matches. Now Schofield has the liberty of about 10 metres.
Well, you saw Kennedy go with a boomerang there because he had nowhere to kick it. Oh, that's a horrible turn.
He didn't make the most of the luxury he had, and now it's Sydney players everywhere. Mitchell, oh, he too has made a meal of it. Too much time, perhaps.
No, just poor decision-making for a young kid there. He had options aplenty, just needed to hold the ball. Make McKenzie commit, and the handball over the top will be addressed, I reckon, at some stage over the next 24 hours.
Yes, Lamb was there, ready and waiting. Shuey and Brown with the extra body. Kennedy changes the equation, and what a way he does it too. Came crunching in hard. Parker, Shuey again, scores level, 3.5 to go. Parker might be about to send it back Sydney's way. Went every which way through the air, that one, but behind the end result.
Josh Kennedy involved again at ground level. He strengthened the contest, just puts the ball out the back, and that's what Sydney tend to do a little bit. They have their players sit behind. They know exactly where to put it if it's in a contested area.
Swans with more possessions so far, 90-78.
The Eagles, this is a huge turnaround because at one stage it was 31-11.
A few critical mistakes for the West Coast Eagles. Glass prepared to wear that. He was hoping, I think, the ball might get locked down and they could force a stoppage.
He's in trouble here.
He's gone.
He's making no attempt. Despite the fact that he had a bloke 200 kilos on top of him, he's still expected to just budge a muscle or blink or do something to show the umpire you're trying to get rid of it.
There's McKenzie under all of that. Kurt Tippett gets his first genuine opportunity to get on the board.
I notice coming from the ground with the Swans runner, and he was indicating about the handball.
Well, Tippett makes them pay, puts it through. Outstanding game of footy at Patterson Stadium. Kurt Tippett adds the last goal on the board to the Swans. Adenui again. Big tap down, but it's going to come back the other way. Kennedy for Jesse White, well up the ground. Thumping, high kick. Schofield, clever body use, making life difficult for Parker. A lot of discussion about John Worsfold and his future.
Face the footy!
In terms of the future for this season, a win is an absolute must this afternoon. Rambling, one of the spectators out the back. He's watching as we are. Hanbury get it into Tippett. For a moment, it looked like he was going to gobble that one up as well. McKenzie trying to rectify the situation, but Nick Smith can generate some more movement forward. McVay darting onto the right boot. He heads for Mike Pike. He hasn't seen a lot of it so far, the big Canadian, but there's a couple of nice things there.
Good running from Marston to get down to get the outnumbered player and support.
He's been prolific this year, Marston. Career best form. He's had another 5 today. Ball goes back to the wing. Now it's inside again. And Tippett, strong through the pack. Jesse White had no one to give it to. He had to hope that McVay could come in and make a meaningful contribution. Marston there for the Eagles. West Coast wanted a free. The fans did, and they let the umpire know now.
And I think it was Dan Hanbury, it might have been Luke Parker, John. They've got to be aware that Kurt Tippett is the go-to man. No point jumping in front of him. It'll be a ground level.
Richards. Now Kennedy. Darling's got on the bike, charging forward, using his ability to move, making Richards work just as hard the other way. Here's Wellingham. Has a quick glance inside. Darling, every which way, trying to keep them guessing. He did so he could get the kick forward, but Hanbury again.
Oh, and the work rate once again, from one end of the ground to the other. Brilliant stuff from Dan Hanbury.
Goes to McVay. Canterbury and Kennedy have both had 12 disposals in the first quarter, Jared.
Yeah, and it's McVay who's had the footy over the last 5 minutes. He's had half a dozen important possessions.
Big leap. Might still come to something. Natanui, Dalziel, knew the heat was on. Natanui brushed aside a couple, but then the hair and the whole lot come tumbling down.
Yeah, a little bit stiff there, I thought the big fellow was taken pretty high. A savage tackle from Ryan O'Keefe.
And O'Keefe kicks quickly to Jack. He asked a bit of him. He flew and then got in the back of Gaff. Advantage? Yes, it is. How much advantage? We're about to know with a long bomb. Just the 1 point of advantage. Wellingham has looked pretty good in his first quarter on his return today. Six disposals.
Got to be a little bit careful, I think, the West Coast with just long bombing. They've done really well on the last line, the Swans. So I think they've got the advantage down there, covering off and maybe trying to just pull a short one to drag some of them forward.
Cripps. Well, that ends an entertaining opening quarter. The Eagles started really well with the first two. The Swans hit back with the next three. And Sydney by six at quarter time, Jono.
Yeah, but it's the pressure right around the ground. But West Coast, again, like last week, they've been tackling machines. 31 again in the first quarter today has helped them stay in this contest.
Swans have the edge in the clearances, 12-7. They've been inside 53 more times than West Coast. And as a result, they're 4-4-28. The Eagles are 3-4-22.
They're 45 metres out from goal. And it gives great opportunity for Mumford to run into some really good form. He's up against Natanui now.
Who's ready for action, gets the tap down over Mumford, but look at the Swans storm forward through Jack, puts it out in front, just over the top of Pike, getting back glass, thumps it through.
It was good clearance by the Sydney Swans then. It's just Mike Pike's positioning. He just needs to start back a little bit. He just got rushed up a little bit, allows glass to get up underneath him. He starts back, he actually comes and hits the drop zone of the ball at that highest point.
Natanui, timing only slightly out. All over the top from Bird to Kennedy. Jack to Kennedy again. He just changed his mind up at the last minute. He saw Hanbury.
Yep, just took the front spot and Dalziel gave away the head-high tackle. So it's one out in the goal square if what required.
He compressed the kick beautifully and Pike comes leading hard and takes the mark on the chest.
Well, that's exactly what John Longmire said. They're dropping a bloke back. This time was a one-on-one. And I think when you're up against a tall player, you're going to expect that it's going to be dropped on his head. Well, the players were disciplined enough to leave a bit of space 25 metres in front and the kick went to the perfect position.
So Pike, real sider, then comes in. Doesn't make too many mistakes these days, Big Mike Pike. That's right through the middle.
Guys, the reason they had that much space up there was because the matchup I'm liking at the moment is White, who pushed up onto the wing. He did have Brown come up with him, so that allowed all that space for Pike and Tibbet. You can see now inside their forward 50, there's only the two of them in there. So the space that they've created by pushing White up around the wing to use his athleticism, it's been a really smart move.
Yeah, it's a good point, Cameron. You'll see number 18 come on screen at the centre clearance. He's up on the wing, as you say, and there he is.
He's coming in hard off the wing. Good old-fashioned stuff, that. And it's an interesting way to use the three talls they've got out there, isn't it, in the forward line?
Well, it's good. It's good, Jared, because now you've got White up there and Brown has come with him right up now past the logo, which is so important because it allows Tippett in behind, then the smalls get up, and then they all push back and go back in a wave together.
Natanui. Kennedy and Jack, again, working so well together. O'Keefe, McVay. Over and out. Kennedy up to 15 touches.
They're going to have to do a little bit more on Kennedy. Hutto Hutchins is now looking like he's going to run with him. I think it's various stages through the middle. Certainly the clearances, it's Gaff. But it's Gaff versus Jack. And just got a lockdown on Kennedy. He's doing too much damage.
Drittis, he spotted Hutchins, who clearly didn't trust his left foot. And his right did the job instead.
Fantastic kick in the end. I think he was just kicking for metres. Just get the ball forward. If it goes out of play, it's a win.
Yeah, didn't muck around with any sewing machine. He just turned around and put it straight through. That's his 48th goal for the season, Josh Kennedy. real timely one for the Eagles. Margin back to seven. Mumford got the tap at the death there. There's Jesse White again coming in off the wing. Can they sort it out? The big bodies of the Sydney Swans. Hannabry.
Good hands.
Clean to Bird. And eventually it's Smith. Tippett playing up at centre-half forward at the moment on the 50. Carter, there's a glimpse.
And he's pretty impressive last week as well, Hutto. He's had a good start, the young man.
First game of last week. 11 disposals and a couple of tackles.
He's a little bit nervous with his first couple of kicks. He started hitting some targets. And well, he's on a kid that's not much more experienced than him in Brandon Jack.
Good matchup.
Fifth game for Brandon Jack. Bird. Bird again. Pike, he's a big body, even for Darren Glass. Glass still had an impact on White. Jack again, pops up in the pocket, measured it off. It was far away.
That was really interesting. I just think that Smith didn't compute that Kieren Jack was going to be a left footer, and he was covering for him to come onto his right foot, and then he just got one of the tightest turning circles I've seen in a footballer. Quickly went onto the left.
Schofield scoping out what's ahead. He took the most conservative route in the end. Oh, McKenzie rushed it. Nick Smith has Swans jumpers coming at him on all angles. And he chose a very safe passage to Josh Kennedy, who's done this once already today successfully. Now we're going for another set shot goal. Sydney Swans 5-6 and the West Coast Eagles 4-4. Kennedy looking for his second, his 13th goal of the season. Averages 27 disposals a game. One misses. Battle of the Josh Kennedys at either end. The goal lead so far. Exploring all options in his mind, Schofield, eventually to himself, and pumps it in the direction of Josh Hill. Jesse White, having a strong influence, takes it over the line and out of bounds.
Thanks, Nick. 1 metre.
Big wrestle between Cox and Mumford. Umpire couldn't really adjudicate either way. O'Keefe. Now Hill versus Bird. Lots of appeals going on. Umpire stays silent and we'll have a throw in. Early thoughts on the second quarter then, Jono?
Well, it's just a tight affair again. It was exactly the same in the first quarter, and then it broke away for about a 10-minute period where Sydney were able to get their gut run going and some good forward momentum.
Jack did just that, but he gave it up. And now it's turned over to the dangerous McVeigh. He had his sights set on a long goal. Came mighty close also.
That's a bad sign though. A couple of Eagles defenders who are normally far more composed under pressure have blazed away with kicks in the last couple of minutes. So really critical time now. The Swans, I think midfield has been well on top for the last 20 minutes of this match. And they are just continually pumping the ball inside the forward 50. They need a bit of a spell, these defenders, so the midfield has got to get the ball up the other end of the ground.
Schofield advanced to half-back before kicking, which is a good result, but it looks like it's going to head back towards the Sydney 50. It's Jack Jr. that comes through. Brandon Jack, the long kick to full forward Parker, but class.
He moved the earliest, he read it the best. And again, for about the 2,000th time in his career, he repels an attack.
Been doing that for a long time, the 32-year-old. Out to half-back. It's a smash straight back in. Jack had his hands full that time, but he does well. Flipped it out to Parker. Hands in the air from McVeigh calling flip, but it's Lamb with terrific initiative. Saw off the tackle of Brown, turned around and put it through. Mighty goal from Lamb.
Question for you. If you had these matchups down the Eagles' defence, right now you've got Glass on Mummy, who's been playing on Pike. I think it's time to put Glass onto White. Allow White to run through the middle of the ground because he's not going to hurt you that much. Then put Brown back onto Pike or Mummy and then have Glass play that spare man role and pick White up through the middle. Try and get that spare man down there at the moment.
Yeah, they're being hurt at the present time. I think Brown on the smaller Lamb was really a mismatch that cost them a goal. So we'll just look to see how it unfolds.
Marston, and on the outlet, it'll be Hutchings. He grabs it and wants to go, but the Swans doing those little things that matter, making him back go back behind the mark. McVay's coming here, but he can't stop Cripps. I've talked to already how vital it is that the players that McVay are playing on must be used, but that's a poor turnover, unfortunately, for West Coast. Nick Smith came drifting in to take the mark. So Sydney's lead is out to 16. It's at a vital stage of the second quarter, this match. Wellingham is gone. He feels the ball might have been out of bounds.
Well, the fans aren't happy either over there. I think he stopped because he thought that. You've just got to keep playing to the whistle.
Tippett, Mumford, 1-2, but not the three. Smith and Prittis, Dalziel, Carter. They need to hit a target on the way out. They just have to. And they don't again. It's Rampy, but Kennedy changes the equation, goes in hard, and then had to follow up his own work.
Good pressure.
Rampy, he was diligent with his defence. Grundy gets it back again. Hurried kick, tip it well up the ground. Shuey down there with McKenzie. Bolton, Mumford came through. Jack clambering after him. McKenzie, still they got it moving forward. Parker, Bolton wants it in return. But Parker goes his own way and turned around and put through another stellar goal for the Swans. What a team they are. Big second turn from the Sydney Swans. They have taken control for the moment. 3-4-1 straight.
Yeah, look at that. Seven scoring shots. They've just dominated the ball, pumping it forward to centre.
Need to rest that momentum back. They've got to get it out of the middle and be able to lock it in somehow.
11 inside 50s to 1, Hutto.
Yeah. And the clearances have been actually on par for the quarter. But once... But it's been in dispute. The Swans have been able to win it, haven't they? Across half-back and really on the wing.
It's their clean hands in tight. That's where they're just a level above at the moment.
I think the work rate as well. And we've seen Hannabury and Parker do the coast-to-coast running, both in defence and in attack. That's been significant.
Smith having a big quarter as well. His fifth disposal. Brandon Jack flashing through. Another ball up needed, out on the wing. 7-8 plays 4-4. Kieren Jack's had six disposals for the quarter.
What a player he has become for the Sydney Swans. Still underrated in many aspects. Kieren Jack doesn't get mentioned at the top end of the tree for midfielders, but that's exactly what he is. He's just a high-quality A-grade midfielder.
He brings such a brilliant defensive side. Yep. But also is more and more dangerous over the years, like Jared, hasn't he, I suppose?
Yeah, the work rate is superb, and his instinct for the game is quite unbelievable, given that he didn't have the usual development.
It's getting frustrating for West Coast fans now. Their kicking efficiency in the first quarter was outstanding, but had a lot of blues in this second term.
Look at that pressure. There were three players went to one. Now, that's just not thinking football from the West Coast Eagles. You get the feeling that fatigue's starting to creep into a little bit for the home side, and the Swans are making them pay the price.
And that price continues to rise. Again, it's Mike Pike, and Nick Smith again in this quarter has been giving them so much drive off half-back.
He's become an important defender for the Sydney Swans. Just so solid, always defends first, beats his opponent, gives no space to his direct opponent. And then at the right times, will link up and support his teammates. 15 gone.
This is getting very serious now for the West Coast Eagles. The Swans lead by 22. And you can add another goal to that tally. It's 8-8 to 4-4. They've doubled them.
Well, there's the chain of events, how it unfolded. But what has been great to watch in this quarter from a Sydney point of view is they're kicking forward of centre. They're hitting targets on a regular basis when they've got that open flow heading towards goal.
And again, that pressure just inside. Knox Prittis doesn't get the ball clear, and the rebound off half-back sets them alight again.
Came from the red boots of Belcheski. The kick out to the wing. Gaff. And there's a fumble. Pressure just mounting and mounting on the Eagles.
Well, it's 29 possessions to 57 in this term, so they just haven't had any control of the ball whatsoever, the West Coast.
Shuey's gone back now as a spare for the West Coast Eagles.
Mumford and Cox doing their thing. Lamb gets it in there. Here is the spare. Shuey stretching it out. Cripps gets it across. Young Carter, it was in fact to Smith.
And they've got the two on one. This should go to the other end of the ground. And they've got to work hard to go over and get some space.
Dalziel may sell, just have to wait a fraction longer than desired. You can pop it over the top, though, to Schofield, who's lending a much-needed hand up there on the wing. And he's got some dash. We've seen him before running hard and kicking well to Darling.
Well, that's their best passage of play for a while. A little bit of work rate added to some good foot skills.
Well, for the first time for the quarter as well, they got the spare behind. So it started with Shuey, who worked his way into that contest as the spare. And then that created the overlap run, some good gut running from Selwood, from Dalziel, to create this.
It's been all or nothing for Jack Darling this year. Four bags of five, three bags of three. So 29 goals in seven games, just six in his other eight. So from a West Coast point of view, I hope that he's on. Let's have a look at the kick. Distance we've tested everyone, but it's a behind only. Great either there for Shuey. On the bench. Some medical care.
Too easy for Sydney as well to get that out. That was a set shot from Darling. West Coast should have their zone set up. Malcheski shouldn't be able to get the ball from fullback and kick it straight down the corridor to a Sydney player with no man on him. Or through a zone not set up correctly.
Cox, double effort was good. Pritis, Marston. Is Darling again. Had three Swans to contend with, and one of them, Nick Smith, having a mighty game. And sharing it well with Everett. Plenty of Swans on this side to work with. There's one of them, Grundy, ready to release.
That's a great kick.
Yeah, it was. Hanbury just got away from Dalziel.
Man on man, West Coast. And that kick just set up his teammate perfectly.
Here comes Grundy again. That's not so well placed. Last kick now. Will this amount to anything? He had a glance forward, didn't like anything, so he's gone back.
Well, Gaff's running free at the present time, and he's not working into some space. He's got to get himself dangerous.
Selwood crept to the defensive 50. He's been forced to go down the line where the Swans have an extra number, and O'Keefe did that easily at the moment. This game being played totally on the Sydney Swans terms, Jono.
Well, it is, and in their forward half of the ground as well, Hutto.
Pumped high for Tippett. He looked likely, but McKenzie did the job. Carter left it behind. Tippett's follow-up work exemplary. High kick from Lamb. This will worry everyone in West Coast colours because the Swans are swarming through. Kieren Jack, they just can't stop him, and they can't stop the Swans.
It's a bit of news down here, boys. Shuey's getting his right hamstring worked on pretty hard down here at the moment. And Malcheski also, he's come off a couple of times complaining about a right leg injury.
We saw where Kieren Jack has been winning the footy. It was pretty much ever at the moment. And that's such a trademark of the Sydney Swans, the areas that they are able to cover during games, and as we've said, and they kick goals as well, Jono.
Well, they do. And you look at their top three ball winners at the moment. 15 disposals to Jack, 16 to Hanbury and Kennedy, and three goals between them. But they've had seven scoring shots for three players.
Oh, wow, that's a big miss by the umpire on Schofield. And the Swans might be out of profit. West Coast need to dig very deep at the moment. That could be, that is holding the ball.
Well, it looks like Adam Selwood may have been given a role to lock down on Joe Kennedy. And he's pushed himself forward. Just got to find a couple of goals before they go in at half-time, the Eagles, to give themselves a little bit of confidence momentum back.
Craig kicked it in. Everett thumped it out. Now Gaff winds the handball back to Wellingham. Quickly into gear. Wasn't perfect contact, and it ends in Sydney hands. Richards takes the mark. Josh Hill only two disposals. Has laid four tackles. Been able to hit the scoreboard so far this afternoon. The Swans again, piece by piece. Bolton, Hite was on the side of Schofield. Jack still a chance to get involved. Schofield switching the handball out. Ash Smith got the footy with some instructions from Glass to Marston by hand again. Impatient crowd hoping that something will come of this for the Eagles, but again, it doesn't.
Ramp. Just desperation, isn't it? Right across the field for the Sydney Swans, and it's some of the younger players. Nick Smith setting the tone. Rampy on that occasion setting the tone defensively in their setups.
Oh, he's come through. About six players.
Kennedy again to McVeigh.
Started with Brown hanging onto his back.
McKenzie beautifully off to Mitchell. Hanbury had a little reconnaissance to look into the forward 50, and he saw that Lamb. He just delayed the kick perfectly. He saw him early, Jared, and then just waited, and then Lamb was close to goal by the time he was ready to release.
Gold pass for that one, Hutto. That was absolutely superb, the kick. Fainted to the middle of the ground and then just cut it across his body. And he gives Lamb the opportunity to get his second for the quarter.
We've seen the Swans. I was in Adelaide the day. They absolutely destroyed the Crows earlier in the year. And I reckon that sent a few shockwaves around the competition. And I think this quarter is as well. It's been a real masterclass so far from the Sydney Swans. And Lamb is able to thread another one. His second of the quarter. And they lead by 39 points. All you can do is just applaud, just sit back and enjoy. They've kicked 6 goals, 4-1 in this quarter so far, and there's still some time to go, still 4 minutes of action to go. Hutchings. Got any suggestions, Moons, for them down there?
Start winning the clearances, Hutto. Start getting some contested ball and go and find your man when the opposition have it. You look at the numbers through the middle, Hanbury, Jack and Kennedy, all just massive numbers. O'Keefe as well. It's the midfielder that are really dominating at the moment.
McCrae gets it in. Grundy scoops it up. Couple of don't argues.
Good tackle. Can't That's
argue.
A start.
Yeah, can't argue with that in the end. Well done, Josh Kennedy. It was good follow-up work.
Well, it was a centre clearance. It went forward. Bit of pressure. But in the end, it was really just one man's individual effort that upset Grundy.
Sometimes that's a spark, though.
Kennedy for his second of the quarter and the match. Oh, it's just mind-boggling, isn't it? But it works. It's a goal.
It is, because even last week, I think there were less last week than there are this week.
There was so more, there's
just so, but anyway, it's effective. And as we always say, when you shot a goal, it is your last few steps that always matter. That's where you get the momentum through the ball, you get it going, you get your body shape right. And Josh Kennedy does exactly that. So you look there, the Coleman medal race. It's rough head in front at the moment, but Kennedy continues to close the gap.
Quite a battle. It's been a reasonably low-scoring weekend for the major goal kickers. Kennedy now closing in on Jared Roughead, who's on 50 in the race for the Coleman medal. Matanui, there's a little flip out the back to Prittis. Most importantly, can that goal give something for the West Coast Eagles to believe in, to think they're still in this game? Matanui slung, but kept it moving their way. Jack will send it hard back the other. Dalziel flipped it out to Prittis, and they're working now. With some purpose in mind. Brown to half forward. They come from every angle. Darling cleaned up a couple, even his own teammates. Doesn't matter. They have to get hard at the footy. Around the corner goes McVeigh. Back to him in the melting pot on the wing. Bodies going crashing and crunching in. And the footy going over the boundary line and out of bounds. 3 minutes to go in this half, Jono.
Well, you see there, Shuey in the hands of the trainers again. He was in amongst it there. Nick Natanui was getting flung around. I think Shuey was involved and got tangled up in all of that. So he's a bit sore at the moment.
He's also on his own.
Mumford taps it down. This man's on his own too. How that could be possible, I don't know. McVeigh to half forward and it's out of bounds.
Well, that was his man, Hutto.
Okay, that's how. Hey, it was pretty obvious, wasn't it, really?
Both staying each side of the contest. But look, McVeigh's at the moment. He's just doing what he wants as far as his sweeping role. And again, West Coast, they start needing to go man-on-man a little bit more, making it more of a contest, because they're just running it out right now, Sydney.
Well, they've put Marston over onto Kieren Jack. Try and quell his impact, because it's been extreme.
Wow, Prentice just about beheaded that time. Very late.
Finally, the whistle.
He's really worked hard, as Matthew Prittis, and yet every time he gets a possession, there's somebody from the Swans putting a hand on the back or a smother of his kicks, which has kept his efficiency and his effectiveness down a little bit.
Kennedy, late decision not to pass. That was so clever from Darling. It was brilliant stuff. He led, first of all, back towards goal, and then when that was covered, came back up to the footy.
Well, it's a great call, Hutto, because he was there. Kennedy did see him, but Andreas Everett came across, closed up the space that he was trying to go into initially, then pushed off Everett, back at the kicker. And because of that speed of movement, that's what attracts the kicker's eye. So Kennedy's focus was on him the whole time.
Here's Jack Darling. Still looking for the major openings. And that's not going to count it, I'm afraid. It's a behind. Margin is 32 between those two sides.
And again, quickly out of the defence. And another tackle miss from Willing.
It's okay if it's a quick point, Jared, but it's up from a set shot, so there's time to set up to get that zone right.
Brandon Jack to Kennedy, flew to foot again. Lamb already with a couple of goals in the corner. Little touchdown before he launches deep. Kieren Jack's trying to wind his way to the front of the pack. He can't. And Glass takes the mark, and Big Cox ready to break across to this side of the ground. He's got it now in the back pocket. Pops over the top to Adam Selwood. A glance up the clock. There's a minute 18. Lacroix had to wait. The Swans have just about got the bases covered now. Frustratingly so for West Coast. Needed a really good kick. Carter had to grit the teeth there and take the mark.
Quite a good run then, Carter, because wasn't used back in the middle when he was open. Got back around, provided another option.
Nothing for him down the line at all.
Good, kick,
good decision.
One, huh?
It meant there were some numbers in the middle. Glass, and we've got 51
They're
seconds
here,
of counting. He can go to Cripps, he can go to Wellingham. And now Gaff would be the next option. If he can, oh, he's got to move it swiftly. Oh, and he moved it swiftly, but errantly. And out comes Grundy. Oh, good. Well, it was a good effort from Cripps.
Well, it was a great effort from Grundy as well. He came from 10 metres out from goal to cut that off outside 50.
Now, 30 seconds. There ought to be some urgency about the ball movement here for Marston. And just stays in the field of play with Wellingham. He's coming in for his ninth disposal. Closing in on half-time, all too quickly as far as the Eagles are concerned, because not a moment to waste. Lacroix, he had an option and he didn't take it. They need a big mark. They need Matanui. Oh, they're not going to get the time to get it into him. Prittis, and the siren will sound. Frustratingly so for West Coast fans, but just let's all just applaud the Sydney Swans. They have been absolutely outstanding. That second quarter, they kicked 6-4 to 2-2, Jono.
Well, they did, and it was, they kicked 3 points, the first three shots at goal in about 5 minutes of footy, and then from there, they started to get on the scoreboard in a real positive fashion. 5-1 from that point on, and dominated that quarter of footy.
Yes, it was an impressive display. You go through the middle of the ground, it's Hanbury, it's Jack, it's Kennedy, it's McVeigh sweeping, it's Bird locking down, O'Keefe also doing a great job. And the Swans lead at halftime by 32 points with John Worsfold, a lot of work to do.
And a lot to talk about at halftime, not just this match, but all the stories of the weekend, so stay with us. Sydney Swans, and they are in full flight in the second quarter. Let's see what the Eagles have brought with them for the start of the third. Natanui beaten by Mumford. Wellingham in the middle. A high one. He camped under it for a while. Bird, typical Sydney determination. Take the mark. Good tackle from McVeigh.
Be disappointed, Bird, because he had the open jump at that ball and just didn't get his hands right when trying to mark it. Just needed to wrap that ball up tight and would help protect himself as well.
Hanbury sends it out of the wing. Glass was losing ground. He was trying to hang on for dear life. So it looks like we've got the sub made. Caleb Morton's on the ground.
Luke Shuey's out of the game.
That's not going to help the Eagles' cause, you wouldn't think. Mumford down to Kennedy. Saw off a couple and then the handball to White. He's got Rampy running and there he is. Just had to wait. I really would have desired. Allowed the Eagles to come in. Matanui, the knee's dirty. Got it out to Brown and then to Hill.
Well, they haven't seen the ball, unfortunately. Jack Darling was going charging down the middle and went the other side of his vision.
Rich Richards had a different view, of course. So he was able to get it to Everett safely. He's bounding forward, sending it high. Bolton in front. The spoil was effective. Tippett kept on coming. Lamb again looking for his third. And it's thinking about it. It's the post.
Just on that sub, guys, it is Morton's obviously on and Shuey's off. You can see him there putting the vest on with the jacket and tracksuit pants. So it's obviously a fair bit of pain.
Well, a real shame for Luke Shuey and the Eagles, because you'd reckon it won't be just a one-week injury. But an opportunity for Carl Morton, who's trying to reignite his career.
Darling, so all hands on deck for the Eagles. Takes the mark at half-back. A little glance into the middle. Guess they've got to take a chance or two. That was bold. Got it to Glass, and now to Gaff on his left. Kennedy demanding it. And takes the mark. Forward of the centre. Looks up into the fifth. Josh Hill is the man on his own. They've got, if he can get it in deep enough, and here is Hill. McCrae's working back to the square, but now Hanbury is going to help out for the Swans. McCrae still seen there. The zigzag.
Well, he's entitled to go back and have a shot. There wasn't an obvious opportunity. They've got Nat Nui on the line. They've got Darling also.
19 goals for the season for Josh Hill. And Nui pitching over the top. It's a minor, so the Swans lead now is 32.
And again, a very quick kick out. This time the Eagles press a little bit more resistant. Let's see if they can block the holes.
Fay, done from McKenzie. Hill changed his mind at the last minute. Swinging around, Selwood succumbed to this relentless Sydney pressure. Rampy up on top of him. Hutchings, Smith again. Oh, he tried to angle it off the outside of the boot. Unfortunately, didn't go the way he was after. So no gain, ground or conceded in the first 3 and a bit minutes of this third term. Hanbury sends it up to the wing. White and Brown.
This is where West Coast, this is what John Worsfold's asking for, getting numbers around, but then getting first hands on the ball from these situations when he spoke to Cam Mooney just after half-time.
Well, he's looking for a response here, John Worsfold. Not even worried about the result. He just wants to see a plausible, a serious result and response from his players on the ground.
Hutchings to Prittis. Intended consequences there, and now the Swans are bolting again. Jack just missed the mark on it for a rare occasion. It's Ash Smith in amongst all of that. Just did enough for the umpire to keep the whistle away. And now we're going to have another restart out on that wing. So it's hard yards at the moment for the West Coast Eagles. Trying to dig in here. A trial by 32. Gets the tap down. Mumford.
This was in the first passage of play for West Coast going forward. And look, they had the overlap here with Kennedy getting out. Then Selwood pushes down through the middle of the ground. And this is where Sydney start doing their best work. They all start pointing. They all roll over with each other. And yes, Josh Hill may get out, but he gets out wide because Sydney defenders take the most dangerous.
Back to the live action. Slapped away by Mitchell. White again as they start to gather the numbers at half forward. Didn't panic when he slipped. Got it off to Hanbury. Well done, Selwood.
Yeah, once again, good athleticism from Jesse White. He went down, the boots failed him, but he was up and he quickly got a handball away. He's fighting for his spot. He knows there could be something significant on the end of it at the end of the year. He's got to keep his position, and there's some high talent looking to take it.
Quick kick from Jack. Eagles have an extra. Tippett, and now O'Keefe. Smith. Might have earned a free for that.
Well, he has, but it's even that one there, Jared, where O'Keefe gets to the front first. That's the one where Prittis' opponent needs to push in front of him to get that front square ball first, because that's what the coach is asking for. In first, get hands on it first.
Yep.
Stop those deep entries from Sydney.
Most delicate of kick-ins, and the next one down the line. He pipes monsters Wellington, takes the mark. Tippett screaming for the top of the square. It's coming, and here comes Tippett. Doesn't quite make it. definitely didn't quite go as far as desired. And now Morton has it in his hands and stretching out Gaff again, that familiar gate. And he kicks it out very, very wide as they hug the boundary.
Good take from Lacroix. Wasn't the easiest of kicks.
It's a long way home from there.
Master's come off the bench.
Yep.
But can he get in his vision?
Smith couldn't see him. Still didn't spot him in the end. So maybe he can be involved in the next passage of play. Gaff, the stump coming on his wrong side. So turns onto the left. Angles the kick up into the middle. Brilliant anticipation again by O'Keefe. Saw it all before his eyes. Got it down to Bird and out of Lamb. Tip it. Got in a good position, got McKenzie where he wanted him. The kick went out in front. McKenzie came late, got it away. Reflexes had to be quick from Brown. Got it across to Natanui and now to Prittis. They can run from half back at last. Selwood, sharp kick into the middle. Again, Lacroix, and they've worked it to half forward. What's going to happen here? Cale Morton's going to have some time. Cale Morton's going to see it all ahead of him. From 40 out, Cale Morton for the Eagles to endear himself to the locals. He puts it through. Maybe that could be the start of something.
A real opportunity now for Cale Morton. Here's the chain, how it took effect. And it was Cale Morton who took them on. And he let go from about 45 metres out, which was a challenging kick, but he was up to the task. But a genuine opportunity now, as we see the flipper out the back for the Eagles to get back-to-back goals and get back into this match.
Carter to Dalziel, but that's where it ends.
There's the flipper.
Sure, Shane Warne really likes the fact that he's one of his great trump cards. Jared's now a footy term, but it's good stuff, isn't it? Great to watch the artwork of Nick Natanui as a ruckman.
Well, courageous stuff there, just standing totally exposed from Cale Morton. Hands up, could have done a rib there, got it completely smashed as he was. But that's part and parcel of it.
Well, he's playing spare man down there at the moment, Jared, so that makes that last goal even greater, the work rate that we spoke about with Woosh at half-time. Running down the length of the field to kick that goal, then sprinting back to play that spare man again. That's the work rate that he's talking about that they desperately need.
Oh, I'm with you too, Moons. I think pound for pound, they were really embarrassed in their work rate in the second term. We know they had a tough game last week against the Dockers. It was a really tough campaign. In fact, they've had a tough month, but you can't go down in their mind that early in a match, and they've rebounded to some degree. Got to still get another couple of goals.
Got hold of the footy a lot early in this quarter. They've been able to maintain it pretty well.
Well, Sydney still with 9 players yet to touch it in this quarter with nearly 10 minutes gone, and West Coast only with a couple. So that's what it's about, getting their hands on it, getting more players involved in the contest, and slowly you can bridge the gap back.
Parker clinging on brilliantly was Marston. They're the little things that can become big things very quickly. And the ball over line and out of bounds.
Cox and Natanui get involved a little bit more as well in this quarter. Andrew Embley
seemed that interested.
He's just looking down at the moment.
Some numbers.
Working out what to do next.
Holding the ball. Exactly, met with approval. And the Swans players argue over who's free it is. Parker needed a possession. He took it. Malcheski.
He's gone straight to Cale Morton as the spare. He's got to have more impact than that.
Jack in the box, jumped out, picked it up and puts it through. Brilliant stuff again. 14 contested possessions and 2 goals too. What a dynamo he is, Kieren Jack. Swans lead by 32. Cox against Pike. Wellingham starting to find it. Marston up to the 50. They can get it in there. There's some talent for the Eagles, that's for sure. But Darling, and guess who? Ripping it away. Jack decides to bounce. And now the reinforcements. Malcheski clean out to the wing. Parker. Got McVay to work with. Up the next target. He's been pretty handy.
Been late. Very good.
For 7 games, very impressive.
Short. This is Brandon Jack. And tip it. Well done. That time Morton did have an impact. Oh! unfortunately. Sure, it is. It is. Yeah, McKenzie.
Well, the midfield umpire didn't put his hands up, but the umpire deep in attack for the Swans end, he did.
Jude. Thank you.
It's Jude Bolt. Used to be a main player. Now he's just a little a role player, a bit play of the like. Without that's not being critical, just at his age. He'll be there in September, you know that, because he's been there before and he's done it under all sorts of pressure. And he just coolly goes back and drills another for the Swans.
A couple of stars the West Coast that are sorely missed at the moment, Selwood. Inside 50 numbers tell the story, 36 to 17. It's a real effort required now for the West Coast Eagles.
Wellingham paddles. He had someone in mind too. Gaff just eased the ball. Darling, was there any contact high? Lots according to the umpire, O'Keefe.
Just so many red and white jumpers around the contest. I mean, this is the sort of simple stuff that John Worsfold will be really exasperated about. Numbers at the ball. He spoke to Cameron about it. He's getting half a response, but it's going to have to double.
Gaff, does he chance his arm? No. Sets it up, gives everyone an opportunity to fly, and they did. Hill walked that tightrope. Mitchell knew what to do. Smith, McVeigh, good effort to keep it in. From Schofield first, then Natanui, then Wellingham. Now Morton dabs it back for Glass. Does he wind up the old stage? And no, gives it to the youngster in just his second game. Carter could have handballed to Hutchings. Instead, he had a fly at goal.
Just Lamb on the smother, then just came in with the one hand. Handball was over the top, but had that chance. And Rampy showing some good strength there.
Maybe a little enormous strength, a little bit high perhaps, but geez, he's got good upper body strength. Yep.
Here's Natanui.
That handball needed to go again, Hutto. The
give from Carter.
Yep.
Smith. Short to Lamb. His 14th disposal. Somewhat of a breakout game for Lamb. Along the wing. Jesse White continues to grow in confidence, and the Swans are spreading hard inside the 50. It's Mumford and Bird versus Morton and Wellingham. Morton came hard enough, left the footy behind initially, but was able to gather it. And now they can work the outer side of the ground. Tough one for Cripps, though. McVeigh turned around. Good resilience stuff by the Swans skipper. Look at him go hard. Cripps equal to the task on that occasion and forces a draw. And the plaudits of his teammates. What a magnificent season Jared McVeigh is having. Another 14 disposals today. 13 kicks and one handball. Oh, that's gone.
He did get it on the boot in the end, but not according to the umpire.
Huggies his case. Meantime, the footy goes back to the 50. Hill! Using the R's, but not the mark.
Jack Darling caught the big knee in the back of the head.
Rampy. Breaks through. He might get it back. No, they're going to change direction. Instead, across the ground, Bird. Wide kick for Jesse White. Now Hanbury shapes the kick back for Mitchell. Brown's there. Has good support. Morton, oh, he hesitated with the handball. Maybe a little lucky to get away with that. It's an interesting kick. Out wide for Dalziel. Gaff comes off the ground looking exhausted. The job is really ahead of the West Coast Eagles here. 37 points behind. The Sydney Swans have had a great weekend if they can go on with this, with both Geelong and Fremantle losing. Melcheski. Deep kick for Tippett. McKenzie has position A and should be able to use it. He's got Morton there in support. It's all the short stuff, though, for the Eagles at the moment. Glass changes things up a little bit. Still there. They're hemmed in. Marston can go over the top to Brown. That opportunity is passed now.
Selwood pushing out the middle. In fact, it's Schofield.
Takes it. And good run. That's what they needed, some run and some hunt from behind. Smith to half forward. Wellingham over his head. Kennedy, the cruelest of bounces, really. and it favoured Grundy, who was last on the scene, but he's the man who was able to take it away and kick it to Melcheski.
Well, Mumford's working really hard down the middle, providing him an option, but also getting that Nui out of the way.
It's a 50, I suspect, against Wellingham, was it? Jono just, I think he's the only one anywhere near the scene of the crime, so I guess he must have walked over the mark.
Too short.
So Melcheski, he's got tip it deep. A little predictable, and the Eagles' defence on guard. But it's been a good quarter, really, for the Swans, because the Eagles have come hard and have made no ground. That is holding the ball. Here's the 50 from Wellingham.
Just put the arms up as well.
Put it in
so you, put the, you get in the area, but then if you put your arms up as well, that's an automatic 50.
It's such an irrelevant thing, though, really. I'm sure why it's 50. Even though we've heard the explanation,
yes,
50.
Punishment doesn't really fit the crime there, does it, Hutto, on that one?
No, I don't think so. 12-9-81 to 6-8-44.
Shane Mike, dominate.
Bring back the 15-man penalty.
Parker into the 50. Again, Morton working overtime back there. Tippett found a way to get it on his boot. Jesse White and Glass. Morton to Glass again.
Well, we've got some numbers here, Hutto, and they should be able to just spin this one up the ground, except it was dropped, and here come the cavalry with red on.
Yes, and they come in numbers. Hanbury, little flick through. Kieren Jack, always team orientation. Jesse White thought it was a chance for a bit of a specky and a fly. Lamb, Bird, and Glass. But it's all being played in that end of the ground at the moment.
Second quarter was the same. West Coast started this third quarter really well, but Sydney have been able to just take control back again.
Through the legs of Hanbury. Hutchins. Hanbury again. Just keep feeding it around. Back out to Hanbury again until there was an opening. Cale Morton.
He's getting the right spot. He's seen plenty of footy. This will be disposal number 10 for the quarter.
Running around in circles there. Out to the wing. Rampy will come late. And another commanding performance in the air from the Swans to smash that overlap.
Jared, there's no point having a spare man if you're not going to then run the ball out with handball. If you're just going to get it and then kick it back down the line, it just defeats the purpose of having that spare man down there.
Yeah, spot on. If you can't turn it into an attack that gets it out of the defence, you might as well just go one-on-one. But the Swans just doing it too easily at this stage. Grundy having a good quarter. And they're going to spin the ball the other side of the ground. They've got Smith wide. The kick, all not all that flash. And here's one of the great pressure forwards in the competition, Darling in pursuit.
Went to ground though, and Richards able to gallop away. Good work from Darling, didn't give up on it. The kick away, look at that. It's a bullet to Kieren Jack.
He went back to Richards. Richard used the ball pretty well, but not as well as Melcheski. Could have stayed probably with Melcheski, waited for more reinforcements before pushing back up to put some pressure on Richards.
Mike Pike drags it down. Now Parker.
And the race is on.
Let them run. And Everett does that. Taking no chances with the time to bend down and pick it up. Or he's just about cooked though, Everett.
He's warm.
Well done, Schofield. He was in hot pursuit. And just didn't quite work out there for Andreas Everett, did it?
Did it.
Quick ball. And it goes for Cox.
Pretty stagnant though. He's looking for something up the ground, and it's Gaff that provides it. And they're going to need some more to take a lead from his work rate.
Dan Cox, just the 5 disposals for the day.
Well, that's one of their problems. They're just not getting that same level of athleticism and extra midfield results out of the two big blokes.
Yep. Here's Kennedy. A long, long way away from where he'd like to be. All he can do is heave it. Get it up quickly. Parker into spoil. Melcheski likewise. Hutchings and Hill. Richards. Oh, that's in the back. Oh, the boy didn't see it. Maybe he over-exaggerated. Jack. And Schofield. Kennedy.
Interesting handball.
Oh, Mumford's gone down. He's up quickly though this time. Glass. Sells on Selwood.
They've held on pretty well here, the West Coast Eagles. They've controlled the ball, but it just seems very difficult for them to conjure up a score.
really been able to actually get it into the 50, though, have they, with any real style.
On the chin. That's it. It's just been that high ball going in. That's where Sydney like to get their numbers around. It's just so tough around the footy.
This time it's Lacroix playing loose, but the bounce of the ball has absolutely killed him. Not a bad tackle. Mumford let it go to ground. Good effort from Lacroix.
Very good effort. Again, slight skill error lets them down. And the Swans are on the fly again, or are they? Lamb. A little tender with the handball, and does it go anywhere?
Update possessions now, Lamb. Starting to rack them up.
Out of bounds on the full.
So stagnant though, West Coast here, Jared. You look from where Smith is now, there's not much movement going on. They're starting to get things going now, running into some space, but they're just forced so wide.
Need a fast break, inside handball, and away they go.
Dalziel to Hutchings. Looks up, all his teammates were coming at him.
Once again, just that pressure from the Swans. This time it slides out.
Heartbreaker for Cripps.
Yeah. Boundary umpire has not read the script as far as Cripps is concerned. Spares at the back here, the Eagles, if they can get it into the middle, but the Swans are just dominating inside.
Now Kieren Jack again. That's a rare error. Wasn't a great handball at all. Wellingham. The numbers gather through the middle for the Eagles. Wellingham again, the former Pie. Here's Cripps. This time he looks up, sees nothing but Swans jumpers ahead.
Well, no one's pushing forward, Hutto. Everyone's got their hands on the hips.
Yep.
High ball up into the 50. Opportunity for the Swans defence, first and foremost, though. O'Keefe and McVeigh and Melcheski. Parker, it's a similar story and a disappointing one for the Eagles fans at the moment. Jesse White flew high, but Pike dragged it down. He's had more and more influence as the day's gone on. Such a solid mark. O'Keefe. Tough for Brandon Jack that time. Young Carter takes the mark. Smith. Morton in the middle. He goes back to Cox, and the frustration builds for the West Coast fans. Gaff. No free kick, so it's a Sydney ball again. McVeigh, he's got Kieren Jack is powering forward here, but the kick just didn't have it. Oh, it might get through to him after all. No. 20 seconds to go in this third term, and there's some very tight boys out there, Moons.
They are, Hutto. And look, the one thing you talk about when you're an interstate team coming across here is trying to shut the crowd, and I actually heard the boys say it in the warm-up. You really want to just make the crowd quiet, and you can hear an absolute pin drop out here at the moment. The only time they're actually saying or doing anything is just in disappointment when the Eagles boys do something wrong. And you spoke about the work rate just before, Jared, about those boys not pushing inside 50. You could see the wall of Eagles players just outside, and that's just really poor work rate, as we've spoke about. None of them pushed in there to make it an even number if they could. Then you just saw Sydney just handball it out with two or three extra numbers. It's just too easy.
Only seconds remaining, and they pass now. The siren sounds. Sydney have won another quarter. Quite quarter it was in terms of scoring. Just 2-1. But Sydney lead by 37. Still a glimmer of hope for the West Coast Eagles, but that's all it is at the moment. They need to get things going very, very quickly their way, Jono.
Well, they do. The start of the next quarter, they need to get the first two on the board, start to build that momentum. Sydney have just dominated this game so far.
We're back with the final quarter right after this.
Yeah, many of their midfielders contributing. Dan Hennebury's got one. Kieren Jack's got a couple. Kennedy's had one goal too. Jed Lamb's kicked a couple. Luke Parker's got a goal. Tom Mitchell had opportunities. They have spread it right across the board.
Mumford. Down nicely by Pritis. Willingham gets them up towards full forward, the centre-half forward area. Rampy, Marston. nothing doing now.
Now, that's where Sydney is so good, and they have been all day today, in the fact that if it does go forward like that with a bit of a chaos ball, they're just able to lock it in and get themselves set.
Free kick to Mumford. Yeah. And Louis looks a little confused by it all.
I can see why.
Ted Richards sends it out for Pike. It's a hard effort from Tippett. Not paid. Brandon Jack laid a tackle. Maybe the man didn't have the footy. Wellingham. Schofield saw off one. Good ball movement by Hands. It's the area where Sydney have had the advantage for much of the day. Cripps. Long kick to Cox. Plenty on it. Everett got back. Did he interfere? No, he didn't. He just won the ball and gave it to Richards. Darling. McVeigh.
Ooh. Good pressure here from the Eagles. This time the Swans pull a free kick, but just some positive signs here for the home team. The Swans now under the pump. And a high tackle and a good decision.
Smith, a little nifty give out the side. Everett to halfback. Tippett. Flying effort from Wellingham. His form's been pretty good, really. His return, McVeigh. Hanbury for Jack. He's going again to half forward to Jesse White, bounding out confidently. Mumford's pushed really hard forward. He hasn't seen him. Instead, it's short to Bolton. He'll look up now and he'll see Mumford, the height. He's got the advantage, the size over Gaff. He's got to get up and take it, and he does.
Oh, great, Mark. I mean, that's just a magnificent passage of play for the Sydney Swans. They got it off the half back line, but it was the work rate of Kieren Jack that just got in front of Andrew Gaff that put some space between the Sydney Swans and the West Coast Eagles. He basically made the break that counted.
And again, we saw it with Hanbury earlier. It all started back with Mumford getting that free, which we thought was a bit dubious, and he's going to be on the end of it. It's just amazing the amount of work rate in modern footy, but particularly from this Sydney Swans team. Shane Mumford puts it through.
Guys, you talk about Mummy's work rate. I mean, this is a guy when he was at Geelong. We used to do the 5K rower together, and he put in times that would have put him in the top five Australian best times in rowing. So he knows how to work. He's an absolute animal when he gets on the track.
Hard kick forward from O'Keefe. Down to Pike, wandering ball. Pike went down. Glass.
Here's the rebound. Off the half back line, this is just a long kick, Ian Hope, and this time it hits a target.
It does. It was from McKenzie and it went to Darling. Posting up well was Kennedy and then to Marston. We've got the edge here. Lacroix might have to go by himself. It's a little bit of an in-betweener. And Dalziel's sort of hoping for a free kick.
Well, here it is here, and this backs up what you're talking about. There's his work rate just coming into screen. So that's from the back half of the ground where he's been able to work to there. Keep moving in, keep moving in. The kick in the end is fantastic. Selwood can't do enough. Either can Gaff, and a big mark to Big Mummy.
Well, the hard work got him the mismatch, didn't it, in terms of the size of his opponents. Here's Lacroix again, perhaps on the brink of something for the Eagles. In good position, Darling. Maybe drew some contact illegally. No, said the umpire. He's going to pay that one instead.
Now it's just opening up a little bit here, and the Eagles are going inside forward 50. A bit stiff on the previous occasion. This time it looks like it's going to be paid. Darling charges forward, and yeah, fair enough. Over the top comes Malcheski and lobs in his back.
So Jack Darling, just two behinds to his name thus far. That's a good kick. Good strike. And the Eagles get one back. So Nananui's gone down towards the square. Hostilities resume. Cox. Mitchell came through. Schofield. Hanbury. It was actually designed for O'Keefe, but Mitchell got a piece of it. Hurried work, though, marked by Smith.
He's shown some signs, Smith, across the half-back line. He's been one of the few prepared to rebound and work hard with the run.
He's had 22 disposals. It's a good day out. Yeah, we did mention there's been a lot of the Eagles' defence getting way more of the ball than they normally do. 22 to Smith. It'd be a long time since Darren has had 21 disposals. Early into the last. Is that in the back? Not paid. Pritis. Bolton. They're circling a bit here, the Eagles. The Swans, one after another, are picking it up and being shut down.
No, not in the back, over the top. Yep. And lucky not to get a free kick there, Josh Hill, for holding the ball against the Swans.
Hannabury. Oh, it's quickly squashed over the line and out of bounds.
Well, the challenge for the Swans is to keep working. They know they've got this game where they need it. John Longmire won't be giving them any alibi at the present time, but you've got to fight against the natural tendencies to look at the scoreboard and just sit back a little bit. It's something the Swans have been able to do over the years, but it certainly looks as if the work rate's dropped off to some degree.
They're holding the ball here. Pritis not going to make it wait around either. Drives it in for Kennedy. No free kick. Hannabury.
More numbers. Eagles jumpers around the ball.
Richards tried one on in defence. I'm not sure that's the place for that for Teddy. Morton sensed a little opportunity to give it plenty. And just misses the target. The long ball has won already.
They've gone quickly out of defence every time, it seems, but there's the tackle on O'Keefe. He doesn't get it out and he gets pinged.
Stay down for a while. Base kick to halfback. It's coming in again, though. Brown, there's Eagles hands flapping everywhere.
Pritis stays free. He's getting plenty of it at this final turn. He's had plenty of it all day, but getting really effective at the moment.
Moved on, and Cripps just ekes the kick out. And Natanui takes it on the line to give some hope for the Eagles. They'll be within 29 points here.
Well, it works out. Pritis, as you said, finding plenty of ball. Generous Natanui nails the opportunity, but didn't need to play on, so they were lucky there. Could have been nailed, and if he was, the ball would have just travelled very quickly up the other end of the ground. But worked out in their favour, and Matt Nui pushed the full forward and gets a clear jump here. Oh, no, he actually does send it in the end. Grundy just puts himself in the way, but
just a little lucky there, Nick Natanui.
Yeah, well, sometimes when you're on a bit of a dry spell, as Natanui has been, you need a bit of luck. Hasn't kicked a goal in a month. It's his first. Let's see if he can generate some excitement out of the centre clearance. But the other issue is, will the Swans respond? They've just taken a little bit of intensity out of their work rate. And they will smell that they need to actually get back to business.
Well, it's 29 with the home crowd behind them. And consecutive goals, the Eagles. Selwood, Bird. Had lived well. Now, Brandon Jack, a fumble initially. And then a big tackle. He realised it too late. He's been penalised.
O'Keefe has come from the ground, Cameron.
Yeah, he has, Jared. He's just walking in front of me, and he's a little bit sore in the head. No question about it, but I don't think he'll be coming off. He's ready to come back on it.
They still haven't brought the sub Cunningham on at this stage, so they've got that up their sleeve. The Swans, and this is going to be a brilliant tackle from Hill. And Smith caught unawares. Kennedy goes with it. Start to get the adrenaline pumping here at Patterson Stadium. Oh, no.
Had to kick it. The opportunity. Josh Hill's work was very good to chase down with that tackle. And then Kennedy had the opportunity.
McVay giving it plenty. Brown, Mumford, Glass. The tunnel ball action. Lacroix. Escape the clutches. Dalziel. Again, the Eagles start to mount. Hutchings caught in the bear trap, but they kept it moving for a while. Quick kick back from Bird. Selwood should have that covered with the help of Brown.
Got the numbers now.
Yeah,
the Eagles,
they are
dangerous.
Running. Marston. And kept a cool head. Put it in front of Kennedy. He takes the mark. The Eagles starting to wind things up here. The crowd getting wound up as well. 28 points can become 22.
Will become 22, Hutto.
Putting it in the book, Jono.
Straight down. Get the record out. Get your pen, Jared. Mark it next to a goal.
Already marked it for you, Jono.
So Josh Kennedy for his 50th goal for the season. It had to be from a set shot. It had to be through. It's true. And the Eagles, believe it or not, are in this.
Yeah, the sub has been activated down here, guys. O'Keefe's the one who just made a complete liar of me. I just said he was walking around the boundary. He looked fine. He's come off. He's obviously a big crook. And Cunningham's the one that's come on.
Okay, back out of the middle. It's Sydney that needs to respond. And respond they will. And this is the man that's come on, Harry Cunningham. And look at Harry go. Kicks it long towards full forward, and Tipper comes out and takes the mark. What a great move by John Longmire.
Magnificent move from Longmire. And
Harry who, they were saying.
Harry's got some pace.
Yeah.
And Tippett's going around the corner.
And up the stairs, into the second bay, it's a goal. Just his second game, Harry Cunningham, had one last year. After an impressive NAB Cup in 2012. The rest of opportunities this year, but plenty of injuries for the Swans. He made the most of his moment there.
Look at the time in forward half this quarter. West Coast need to capitalise on that. A massive advantage, 72%.
Some hard yards from Bird. It's as if they've been stung into action here, the Swans. And he goes again and put it on a plate for Mitchell. Tippett's one out, so he'd probably be doing well to get it in there quickly to him. Pike's there as well, the big fella. Glass took front position. Pike kept on going, kept on keeping on.
Getting better numbers down to support, though, this time, the Eagles, which hasn't been the case for most of the afternoon.
11 minutes remaining. The Eagles cannot afford a goal here. Bit of confusion, ball thrown up.
But Andre is ever at 100 metres back. Just trying to cover any fast greater opportunities.
Malcheski. Could have been a free to McVeigh. And that's over.
Well, Sydney will always sit up that way. In the grand final last year, it was LRT. He was the one who would just continually sit back and stop the run of Hawthorn trying to go through there. So West Coast have that ability. It's good setup play.
Mumford to Parker. He fought the good fight. Play on the call. It's hard to get it out of there. Lamb all wrapped up. Cox in front. Schofield. Now Marston. Kennedy. Back to Marston again. Pritis. Stays in. Schofield. Go! He's all go! Quick look behind. Nice little work on the outside of the footy, but Richards came and came well. Gave it to Grundy. Didn't help him too much, but look at that ball movement again.
Great hands from the Sydney Swans, and Rampy has been a revelation this year.
He has, and Hanbury saw off that tackle to Kennedy. They've clicked into gear through the middle. Oh, rare fumble from fumble. Jack. Rare fumble. That'll give some hope to the Eagles.
Might have been his first mistake this afternoon for Kieren Jack. Just missed an inside handball, would have ended up at the other end of the ground. Good tap from Dean Cox.
Down to Lacroix and now to Kennedy. And off the left. Darling hits it hard. Looking for some mates. Didn't find too many too close. Handball went to Malcheski again. Right decision at the right time. And the Swans are out of there. Lamb.
Right on Lacroix.
Good hands there from Gaff as well, controlling. Can he hit a target?
He can. Darling, not paid.
She's a concertina in on the key defender, or the key attacking targets brilliantly, the Sydney Swans defence. At that time, they had four around Jack Darling.
3-2 straight in this last quarter in favour of West Coast. Marston.
Interesting.
Darling, top of the square. Hill. Four Swans surrounded him.
Got the numbers back, but in come the support. That's a throw umpire.
Marston kicks the goal anyway.
Well, they're not dead yet, Hutto. They are absolutely still a chance here. Sydney Swans are flagging, and Marston has given them half a chance.
And this is where it starts. Look at Lacroix here, back with the fly. Toughest thing to do in footy. Stand under the high ball, get back with it, but then brings it down to the front. Doesn't take the mark, but then just keeps the ball in the forward half for the West Coast Eagles. They go down, pressure on again inside forward 50. And Marston this time is the one who gets the result.
Well, the hopes start to swell a little more for the Eagles. Under 9 minutes, but 22 points. You know the momentum in modern footy. How quickly you can hit the scoreboard.
Need the showstopper, Jared.
4-3 to two straight.
Good call for it.
And follows it up. Jams it to the poop. To 50. They come from all angles. Lacroix, Everett, face to face. Smith, all these handballs. Well executed this time for the Swans. Hanbury for Rampy. And they all bolt. It's going to go all the way to half forward. Following Morton at the moment. Jack paddles. Tippett. He does stay afloat. Brilliantly caught by McKenzie. Mitchell with old heave ho. High ball. Pike. Kennedy. Pritis. Oh. Ooh. Watch the call, umpire. There's no call. Let's have a look at the kick from Bird. Misses.
Yeah, and I think a few of the Swans players a bit frustrated on that call from the umpire. Pritis didn't look from this distance as if he had genuine contact with the footy.
Nervous glance from the coach at the clock.
And an easy out.
And McKenzie didn't realise it for a moment, but now he does. And kicks it to Selwood. McVeigh, a little confused by where it was, but boy, his recovery was absolutely brilliant, Jared McVeigh. And the kick to half forward, right under the chest of young Tom Mitchell. Kennedy demanding it long. Tippett is down there. So is Pike. Tippett flew. There is Kennedy. Broke through. Hanbury. And they're going to be hard to stop. Who's their best midfielder, Jared? I mean, how do you decide between them all? Hanbury's had 38 disposals and kicked 2 goals today.
I don't know the answer to that, Hutto, but generally the bloke with the ball in his hands will do me, because they've got 4 or 5 not far apart from each other. But at the moment, probably Kennedy holds the status.
Oh, Tippett. Didn't he fly there? Brought it to ground. Hutchings. It's a bit like the old, one of the old favourite sayings of your old colleague David Hooks about the last stake you've had is always the best. The last one who's just done something good. The one you think, how good is he?
You look at Josh Kennedy, yep. He was best of fairest last year, could have won the Brownlow medal. Hanbury was in brilliant form, probably the most in form of the Sydney Swans in the first half a dozen games. And Kieren Jack's been brilliant, and O'Keefe has just been a star over a decade.
And now Kurt Tippett gets another opportunity. 10 disposals. 2 goals straight. That'll do. That will do for the Swans. It's through. They're back out beyond 5 goals. So he's going to end the day with at least 3 goals, Kurt Tippett. But a terrific contest between he and Eric McKenzie. And Anui, there's a little flipper out the back again, Jared.
Kennedy again just having an absolutely stellar 5 minutes.
Tippett, caught a few. Bolton, here he is again, Kennedy.
Well, he had to make a blue. He's not quite 100% accurate, but he's had an incredible 5 minutes just to put this result to bed.
Margin 36 then. Morton has the back pocket to himself. It's the decision to bounce and run. Melchieski. His reading of the footy is just amazing.
He just worked his way into the game today. He was under pressure early and wasn't getting much footy. But as this game has settled down, he's settled down into it himself.
Tippett, Jesse White flew. But Darren Glass took the mark.
He's had a great game, Darren Glass, across that half-back line. He's taken so many marks, intercept marks.
Carter to McKenzie. And up to Darling.
Did well, Richard. He pushed right up hard. He was 30 metres away to block it up. It should create the turnover.
The kick was designed for Cox, but the Swans shut it down very quickly. Mumford, it's out of there through Smith. Cunningham, Parker, knew he was about to be tackled, so just jammed it on the boot. They fight amongst themselves on a rare occasion, the Swans. And it's now over to Andrew Gaff at half-back. Cox is loose in the middle. Pritis will see him. Shorter than that. Bit by bit, it's Morton again. To 14 disposals. Schofield looks like he's been moved forward. Ball is out of bounds. It's 43 to go. Hutchings, good stuff. Gaff on the wrong side. So it's a high ball for Darling and there's nothing he can do there. Kick for Mitchell is clean enough. Now all the Swans players at the other side of the ground in the defensive 50, so Mitchell bides his time. Nothing he can really do other than go as long as he can. And that's a great result for the Swans.
That is a magnificent deliberate. Magnificently disguised. It's just a little tap over the side. Such a strong man is Mike Pike.
We saw that earlier when he was too strong for Darren Glass. Yeah. It doesn't happen too many times. Cox. Down. Parker.
Taken high.
Frustration for Pritis. Good game, Tom Mitchell. Slightly below his very lofty standards for a young man. His 18th disposal, but he's been very, very good. Played his part. The half forward, Mumford, McCrae, squeezed out here.
He's a high-end talent, is Tom Mitchell. We've seen some brilliance from him, both with the ball in his hands and when the ball isn't in his hands. He's won over the coaching staff for his defensive work.
Cox to Pritis, to Gaff, Cox again. Great strength from Kennedy. Still have that extra back inside the 50, though. And it came into play there, Everett. Sees it out, so we're down to 3.5, and there's nothing John Worsfold can do now. They are really staring down the barrel. September looks a long, long way away. Cox. Sharp stuff. Swans, Lamb initially, and then Melchescu to the little lane.
You mentioned the sharp stuff, though. That's been the tale today for the Sydney Swans. That's where they've been so good and a level above on today's performance. Just in around the ball, in around that contested situation where they're so clean with their hands. They get numbers in around.
Free kick to Hutchings. His 18th disposal.
Well, just in full defence mode now, the Swans. They've got all players bar one behind the ball.
Marston takes it. We've crept into the last 3 minutes. It's really been the second term that was the telling one in this game. 6-2 in favour of the Swans. Hanbury calling on the defensive reserves to be a part of it. Well read by Morton. He's got plenty of options in the square. Rampy and Richards will close them out, though. It's through from behind.
Morton today started as a sub. Came on just after half-time with Luke Shuey. Didn't take any further part in the game. So he's finished with 15 disposals. Played as the loose in the third quarter. Picked up 10 disposals in that quarter. Continued good run in this last term.
Pass from the umpire. To Gaff, and here he is again, a flying shot at goal, another miss.
Well, when you consider they were 32 points down at half-time, the West Coast Eagles have done a pretty reasonable job to not be blown off the par, because that's what it looked like it could well have been just in that early part of the third quarter. They've hung on well, fought back well, and they maintain some momentum going into this next month of footy.
Chesky's finest kicking moment there. McVeigh. Smith. Outnumbered, but they've got the man in the right spot. That's Jesse White. Now, he has been a wonderful tail out of today, Jared.
He's been the big positive for the Swans. Hutto, we know the strengths of majority of the list of the Sydney Swans, but there's a huge question mark on Jesse White's future, and he's answering.
A few other teams interested in him too, I would suspect, if things don't go the way the selection table with all the stars such as Adam Goods returns. Right now he's probably in the...
He's in the reckoning. You've got Sam Reid obviously to come back. LRT is the live ladder, and you'll see the Sydney Swans are in that prized fourth position. The Fremantle losing, and of course they're now under the pressure from Richmond, who are just 2 points behind.
And Essendon taking second spot on the ladder today.
There's been a few moves.
Brilliantly worked again from the Swans. Kennedy to Hanbury. They all want to get one last piece. Jack stares it down, and the ball just creeps over the line for a goal.
As you can see, they took it, swept it out wide, and then the inside kick was the dangerous one. Down the middle of the ground, and just 1 minute of play remaining.
Let's see who has the last opportunity. Will it be West Coast or will it be Sydney?
If you put the ball in Kennedy's hands, it'll turn into a goal in this last quarter, but he just fumbled it.
Instead, it's Gaff, maybe going for the other Josh. Rampy intervenes.
What a star this kid's become across that half-back line. It's hard to be a star, but he really has just slotted in, and he's got a huge leg on him.
Played with Williamstown, trained with the Bulldogs for a couple of pre-seasons, did not get an opportunity then, but opportunity now with the Sydney Swans, and just making every post a winner.
Can't believe, just got a reminder about what AFL senior footy's like there. There's Kennedy again, but it falls for Lacroix. Hasty kick. Hutchings still working hard, but Kennedy to be in front in the Coleman. There's a little something for the West Coast to finish the day on. Kennedy puts through his fourth, but it's the Sydney Swans who prevail by 34 points in front of 35,000 at Patterson Stadium. And they look like they are going to be right in the reckoning when the whips are cracking in September. Another powerful performance led by the heart and soul of their midfield. And they've got some of the youngsters, the lesser lights, that are really making their own play to be part of it when it's all on the line at the end of the year.
Well, Hanbury was the star today. Kieren Jack kicked a couple of goals as well. And Kennedy was so good, especially when challenged in that last quarter. And look, right across the board, it was just their work ethic, their strength of movement from defense into attack. That's just a huge bonus for all players wearing the red and white today.
And you've got to consider that they've done the job without Jetta, Goods, Reed, etc. But I think we're going down onto the ground with Cameron Mooney.
Hey guys, I'm just down here just trying to find Dan Hanbury. Hang on a sec, boys. G'day, Dan, how are you, mate? Never easy coming over here and to try and shut this crowd out. That second quarter, mate, you just completely blew the game apart.
Oh, it's one of the hardest tests in footy coming over here and playing against the Eagles. And, they love to play for, so do we. They came out pretty strong and we had to match them. And they came pretty hard in that last quarter, but it's good to hold on. And it's a great win. It's always good winning over here.
Do you guys realise what an advantage you have through the midfield with so many numbers you can run through there?
Oh, no doubt. I mean, you saw Tommy Mitchell and Jed Lamb and stuff running through today. Harry Cunningham played and Brandon Jack. So those young guys are playing their role as well. It's great to see and helps the older guys out.
Thought Pikey was amazing today. We talked about Tippett being such an inside target for you guys, but today Pike really stood up.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, just to have Goodsy and Reedy out, those guys tend to play their role, and Jesse White played really well again. So to have the injuries we've had and the guys playing their roles is really pleasing, and give leads a good step for the rest of the year.
Yeah, I don't want you to be shy on this one. We asked who's the best midfielder in this team. It's got to be you right now, doesn't it?
Oh, mate, there's no doubt. I'm telling you, there's no doubt Kieren Jack's the best going around, mate. He's the hardest 2A runner, I reckon, in the comp, mate. So, he's one of the guys that leads from the front and everyone tries to go follow his lead. So, we all pull our way, and it's great to get a good win over here.
Well, mate, if he's number one, you're not too far behind him. 40 possessions and 2 goals, mate. Well done.
Thanks, Moots. Thanks, mate.
Yes, he was far and away the biggest ball winner on the ground. 40 disposals, 14 contested possessions. The Swans had all the answers when it mattered. A dynamic second quarter setting up the day, and they've won 17-11, 113 to 11-13, 79. was a rivalry that was ignited through a wonderful period of footy, 2005 and 2006. Sydney Swans and the West Coast Eagles. And again, a fierce battle today, but the Sydney Swans had all the answers and they've won this game by 34 points at Patterson Stadium. And that man, Daniel Hannanbury, what a star. 40 disposals, and he's been given the trophy along with Jared McVeigh. Today's game honouring the special significance of the loss of HMAS Sydney 2 on November 19, 1941, off the West Australian coast with all 645 aboard. The wreck was discovered in March 2008. So the Swans winning 17-11, 113 to 11-13, 79. You couldn't help but be impressed by their performance.